We present you now the new version of the Apocalypse by Ruben Irizarry of 2019 with expanded interpretation, chapter by chapter. I hope IT will be a blessing to you. Let's start. Chapter 14, And I saw, and behold the Lamb standing on Mount Zion, and with him 144,000 who had his name and his father's name, which had been written on their foreheads. And I heard a voice from heaven, like the voice of many waters and like the voice of great thunder, and the voice that I heard as of harpists who beat on their harps. And they sang a new song in front of the throne, and in front of the four living beings and the elders, and no one could learn the song except the 144,000, those who have been bought from earth. These are the ones who were not contaminated with women, because they are virgins. These are the ones who follow the Lamb wherever he goes. These were bought from men whose first fruits to God and to the Lamb, and no lie was found in their mouths, without blemish they are. And I saw another angel flying in the middle of heaven, who had an everlasting gospel to preach on those seated on the earth, on every nation, tribe, language and people, who said with a loud voice, Fear God and give him glory, for the hour of his judgment has come and worship him who made heaven, earth, sea, and springs of water. And another second angel continued saying, Babylon the great has fallen, fallen, she who made all nations drink of the wine of the fury of her fornication. And another third angel continued to say to them in a powerful voice, If someone worships the beast and its image, and receives a mark on his forehead or on his hand, he too will drink the wine of God's fury that has been mixed pure in the cup of his wrath, and will be tormented with fire and brimstone before the holy angels and before the Lamb. That is, if someone worships the beast, which is the world government system, and worships the image of it, which represents the beast, he will also receive the judgments prepared for this last day world government. And the smoke of their torment rises for centuries of centuries, and they have no rest day or night, those who worship the beast in the image of it, and if anyone receives the mark of her name, these judgments will also be, for those who worship the beast, that is, the world government system of the last days, and for those who worship his image, which represents the beast, and if they receive the mark of the beast, they will also receive the punishment reserved for the beast. Here is the patience of the saints, those who keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. And I heard a voice from heaven saying, Write, blessed are the dead who in the Lord are dying from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, so that they may rest from their labors, because their labors are still with them. And I saw, and behold, a white cloud, and on the cloud one seated like a son of man, and this is Jesus Christ, who had on his head a golden crown and in his hand a sharp sickle. And another angel came out of the temple, crying out with a loud voice to the one who was sitting on the cloud, crying out with a loud voice to Jesus Christ, saying, Put your sickle in and reap, because the time has come to reap, because the harvest of the earth is ripe. And he that sat on the cloud threw his sickle on the earth, and the earth was reaped. The earth was reaped by Jesus Christ, because he was the one who achieved total and absolute victory as a man. And with the power of his word, he made great judgment of God. And another angel came out of the sanctuary. He came out of the sanctuary on the throne of God, which is in heaven, he also having a sharp sickle. And another angel came out of the altar. Another angel came out of the altar on the throne of God, who had authority over fire, and spoke with a powerful voice to the one who had the sharp sickle, saying, Put in your sharp sickle and harvest, put in your sickle sharp and cuts the clusters of the vine of the earth, because the grapes of it ripened. And the angel threw his sickle to the earth, and harvested the vine of the earth. He cut back what the earth had produced, he cut out all the evil produced on the earth, and threw it into the winepress of the fury of God the Almighty. And the winepress was trodden outside the city, and blood came out of the winepress up to the horses' bridles, for a space of 1,600 stadia, that is, a great battle of God, defending his people in great judgment outside of the city, outside of Jerusalem. And for 279 kilometers, or for 174 miles, a great deal of blood came out.